Hello there. You may remember that a few months ago I tried to test an N-gauge Graham Farish model of the prototype Deltic locomotive that I got as a Christmas present, but that didn't go very well, mainly because of the track that I was running it on. The curves are too tight. There are these Pico first radius curves, which is the tightest radius that they offer, and is really too tight for these locomotives. Bartman, who make the Graham Farish range of models, recommend that you don't use them on first radius curves. I, being new to model railways at the time, when I made that layout, which was almost 8 years ago now, stupidly ignored that. Now it's beginning to become quite a serious issue. When I can't run many of my new locomotives properly on it, which is why I'm making an entirely new layout. As you can see here, it's still in the early stages of construction, but the curves are going to be of a much wider radius. You have the first radius, which is the tightest, then the inner loop on this layout is going to be made out of third radius curves, and the outer loop out of fourth radius. You can see there's quite some difference. This first radius is much tighter than the fourth radius here. So what I'm going to do is run the prototype Deltic model around a few circuits on this fourth radius loop, hauling a total of 9 Graham Farish Mark 1 coaches. Let's hope that this test goes a bit better than the last one. So I just start it up. You can just see the working lights there. Maybe it's a bit of an awkward angle, but maybe you'll see them a bit better when it comes around again. Okay then. Going pretty quickly now. On the older layout it would have derailed by now. It's running a lot more smoothly, mainly because the track is cleaner. I don't have to go through all of that again. I'm actually using clean track this time. The straight bits, which have been reused from the old layout, I've cleaned those before, but the curves, as I explained, are of course brand new. So it's running very well now at just over 50% power. It's kind of difficult to see on this camera, but I'll turn it up a little bit to 80% now. And it's still running. It's running brilliantly, actually. No problems at all hauling these 9 coaches around. Come on, let's put it on to max power and see what it does then. Yes, it's running around perfectly happily. It is absolutely brilliant, I must say. Superb model. The detail is excellent as well. As I'm pretty sure I mentioned in the last video, but that was over 3 months ago. I can't actually remember what I said. But let's turn the lights off to demonstrate the working lights on this model. Yes, they're just about the only light you can see on the video now. It's got blue lights at the front and red tail lights, which you should be able to see as it comes around the curve there. You just caught a glimpse of them. Now, turn the lights back on. If I can find the switch, there we go. And I'll just turn this off. So, there you are. That really is quite an excellent locomotive. But I must echo what Bartman said. Don't use it on first radius curves, otherwise you're going to be disappointed. Anyway, that's all for now. Goodbye.